It's time to get a bit wild as Wilds of Eldraine pre-release occurs the week of the recording of this video. And as someone who has been high on finally getting a Magic product that regular players, collectors, and enthusiasts can actually afford, and putting aside the outside IPs and the crazy prices, I am growing a bit skeptical on a couple things. But there's a light at the end of the tunnel, and I think we got a lot to talk about today. So let's get into it. Wilds of Eldraine looks to pick up where its predecessor left off. Throne of Eldraine was a fan favorite set coming in at a reasonable price with a ton of playable cards, an excuse for people to open the brand new type of booster boxes, collect full art and cool foil cards, and really dig into everything a standard Magic the Gathering set has to offer. And with Wilds, we are getting a new slew of cards, reaching back into some of the same mechanics, some new ones, some of the fan favorite art, and a couple twists with the set that we're going to talk about in this video. But as someone who has been extremely high on Wilds of Eldraine as a way for Magic to become affordable again and release a regular product that has a ton of value, both emotionally and financially, to regular people looking to play Magic, I am getting a bit skeptical and I am worried about a couple things. But as I said in the intro, there's a light at the end of this tunnel. We're going to go over all of that today. But without further ado, we can't talk about Wilds of Eldraine without first starting with the collector booster box. Now, the collector booster box has been something we have highlighted in the previous two Magic the Gathering sets. The Lord of the Rings collector booster box was obviously an all-star and remains one to this day. Game stores were able to make money on the collector box. Enthusiasts who bought the collector box were generally happy with their purchase, and there are tons of exclusive and cool cards that you can only get and are extremely collectible to this day in that collector booster box. Now in Wilds of Eldraine, we go back to our magical roots just a little bit. Before you go into the chat and scream some boomer magic thing that I frankly feel all the time, but I'm trying to train my brain outside of it, where it's like, it's not back to old school magic, there's still a million treatments. Yes, I understand that. But we have set aside the idea of serialized cards, and we have made some treatments that we hope to be coveted to the community exclusive to the collector product. Now, this is where my first concern really starts to gnaw at the back of my mind, if you will. The idea that we will chase down any kind of fancy treatment that doesn't perceive itself, in our opinion, to be collectible is something that hasn't landed well with us in the past. Looking at things like Phyrexia All Will Be One, heck, Dominaria United, and even Dominaria Remastered, some of these cards that are not serialized and don't come in any kind of specific or specialty product have not landed well from a collectability standpoint. More recently, Commander Masters gave this another shot. They said, hey, we're going to print some really cool Commander cards in amazing treatments with awesome foiling, and we're going to sell it to you guys. And we didn't really take to that. It's not something we see the singles moving on the secondary market, and it's not something I see many people proud to collect and show off. The antithesis to that, or the flip side, would be the introduction of serialized cards, which are noticeably absent from Wilds of Eldraine. And while there's an ongoing discussion whether or not serialized cards being printed in every set is good for the future of serialized cards or not, it has come to be shown that we love the idea of being just slapped in the face and told, hey, this is limited. This is something that is limited. It's hard to get. Look, there's a number right on it. Even going beyond that, the complete bundle is something that represented this idea of collectability, this idea of one printing and done, get your hands on it while you can, and a special version of something is something we ate up. Now, the collector box in Wilds of Eldraine is a product that I am concerned with when it comes to meeting these new collectability standards that we have come to love. Now, this is a chance for us to go back and really redefine what we think is collectible and really fall in love with some of these treatments. I think the cards inside the collector booster box are incredible. The arts are fantastic. I just don't know if we are going to take to the idea of collectability, but all is not lost with this idea of this retro shifting of the collector booster product. Not to mention, like, leave in the comment section if you think they're going to reprint it, because without serialized cards, the idea that they could reprint the box is definitely going to be on the forefront of my mind as I go through sales data later this week. Make sure you're subscribed to the channel because that video is coming out. And if you want this set compared to other Magic the Gathering sets, check out channel memberships. There'll be a link somewhere in the comments section where you can get a channel member exclusive video where I compare Wilds of Eldraine standard release to the previous standard releases that we have tracked. But those standard releases went off without a hitch. I think Wilds of Eldraine will too, and there are going to be some all-stars here that are going to shine. And the Enchanting Tales series of cards is going to do wonders for the other product lineups that are not the Collector Booster Box. The Set Booster Box and Draft Booster Box on TCG Player are both bringing in a great price. And mind you, I say this with a grain of salt because it is still pre-release, but the Set Booster Box is coming in at like $118 and the Draft Booster Box is like what, $112, $110, something like that, which are fantastic prices for these products, both for a local store selling these products in person and for people looking to pick up and crack these packs or play with the cards from Wilds of Eldraine. I really love that these products are out there, and I think the Enchanting Tales, the idea that there is one of this print run of card in every single pack, goes a long way. Listen, these are popular cards in many different formats. We have Commander staples, we got some Legacy playables, we got Modern cards in there. Some of these cards are going to be extremely coveted, and while they're going to be printed into Oblivion, yes, one in every pack, they're going to be printed ad nauseum, that doesn't diminish the excitement from opening this product and seeing some of these cards that you really want to put on the table. And because of that reason and the availability of these cards in these lower cost boxes, and I think these lower cost boxes are set up to be all-stars. They're going to be loved by the community. They're going to be great for collecting, awesome for playing with, and I really think this is going to be a win for people to looking to get into Magic the Gathering and buy some product and not have to spend $1 million to do so. This is a regular price product that I think is going to be a hit. Now, will these singles on the secondary market take a bath? Absolutely, 100%. It's going to be open ad nauseum, but I do believe that the emotional ties we're going to feel to this set are going to go a long way. Not to mention that traditionally we love the adventure mechanic, we love the Eldraine art, we love the theme and the flavor, and I think this is going to carry us a long way. I'm happy because it's about time that we got a Magic the Gathering product that is not only affordable and fun, but gives people a reason to open the regular products and be excited about going to their local game store for a draft or cracking the set box with a beer at their desk, whatever your preference is. Let me know what you think of Wilds of Eldraine. If you're going to subscribe to the channel and be ready to, as we go over every single sold listing of Wilds of Eldraine for draft set and collector boxes through TCG Player, if you're excited for that, let me know in the comment section below. I appreciate each and every one of you. Again, check out channel memberships and share this video on social media wherever you engage with Magic the Gathering content, because I really think it helps the channel grow, and conversations like this, they're a lot of fun. Guys, thank you so much for hanging out. Until next time, you all know me. My name is Josh, and we will see you in the next one. Goodbye.